Hi, I'm Ryan Cleathermas with Ketotherm Solutions. In this video, we're going to talk about installing the coil sensor. You should have already determined the correct evaporator coil sensor location. Now, let's review the proper way to physically install the sensor into the coil. When installing the coil sensor, it is essential to make sure that it has good contact with the coil surface. To do this, you must correctly insert the sensor to accurately measure the coil temperature. An important factor in this is the construction of the sensor itself. Despite its physical size, the sensing element is actually quite small. The majority of the housing is there to protect the sensor from the harsh refrigeration environment. It also provides a physical size that is easier to handle and install. The last third of the sensor is the most sensitive and must be placed in the proper position. When installing the sensor on an evaporator with 4 to 6 fins per inch, the fins themselves should be sufficient to hold the sensor in place. On installations with wider fin spacing, a coil sensor clip should be used. There are two methods that can be used to install the sensor. The first is to insert the sensor into the coil at a 45-degree angle. When inserting the coil sensor into the coil, it should be angled upward with the cable hanging downward. This allows moisture to drain away from the sensor. Next, the sensor should be as close to the refrigerant tube as you can without causing damage. Once the sensor is installed, pinch the fins around the sensor cable to keep it in place. The second method of installing the coil sensor is in a vertical position. As the defrost termination sensor, it is important to make sure the sensor doesn't terminate defrost before all of the frost is removed from the coil. In some installations, inserting the sensor into the coil positions it too close to the defrost heat source. Using this second method of positioning the sensor places it vertically between the coil fins. This position places the sensor on the face of the evaporator coil, which works well on air and hot gas, as well as some electric defrost applications. One more thing to consider is that many of our kits are supplied with different color sensors. This will help keep wiring clear and help you standardize installs across locations. Although the sensors are the same, if you have a kit with color sensors, we recommend using yellow and green for the coil sensors and the blue for the air sensor. For more information, visit our website or contact our technical support line.